Good afternoon. How's everybody doing? Thank you for joining. Excellent. So it's been security, security, security all day, I think. We're going to switch gears a little bit and get into some compliance. So this session is around Microsoft 365 and GDPR, and specifically our capabilities around data subject requests. And hopefully you guys can all hear me okay. It's a little loud for me, but you can all hear me okay? Good. We actually just announced yesterday some new capabilities that are available in preview in Office 365 Security and Compliance Center. So after we talk a little bit about GDPR and how we're approaching GDPR at Microsoft, I'm going to actually get specifically into the data subject request experience that's related to the Office 365 content. So I'm Nick. I'm Senior Product Marketing Manager on the Microsoft 365 team. I'm excited to be here with you today. So let's just jump in. So I don't think anyone's probably heard of GDPR, right? No one knows what this thing is. I joke. Of course, it's coming right up. And actually, I just had the chance to talk with some of the analysts at Forrester, and they gave me an awesome statistic where they recently queried a number of their customers to find out what the level of readiness was for GDPR as self-reported by the organizations that they work with. Any guesses as to what percentage of the organizations they talked to felt that they were ready for GDPR? 5% over in the corner. Anyone else? What do you say? Even less? Any other guesses? 30, you're exactly right. 30% self-reported that they're ready for GDPR. Now, Forrester said, we have to caveat that, because we think these customers are overly confident. We think they don't actually know what they think they know. So they estimated it's actually more like 15 to 20%. The penalties for not being in compliance are potentially up to 4% of your revenues, annual revenues. Now, the fines are on a gradation, so it's not as though that will always take place, but it's significant. And the expectation is that the regulators will start slow, looking at, have you made progress? Have you taken steps to put things in place to be GDPR compliant? But that there will be some big cases early on, once the regulation comes into effect. And as you know, it's coming right up, right around the corner on May 25th. And it's not just relevant for companies based in the EU. It's relevant for any organization that's handling data of anyone in the EU, not even necessarily a citizen of the EU, anyone in the EU. So it's broadly applicable to many organizations. So quickly, one of the things that we think about when we try to deconstruct the regulation and work with our customers on how they should think about being prepared is, what does this really mean? What is GDPR all about? And so really, the root of it is a really positive thing. It's about personal privacy rights and enhancing the personal privacy rights to the data that's held by organizations. And this is top of mind. This is top of world news. I think we've all been watching what's been unfolding lately with technology and privacy. And so it's actually very timely that this is coming into effect, specifically with relation to some of the things that our technology organizations in the United States are doing. So there's an increased duty to protect data with GDPR. There's also a mandatory requirement to notify users of any breach that takes place to your organization. So you may have been subject to a couple of breaches, and actually the news hadn't come out for years after the breach actually took place. Now with GDPR, organizations are required to notify a breach within 72 hours. Which is a very significant and quick turnaround. Consumers, yeah. No, EU-based consumers, yeah. Individuals in the EU. So it's only for the EU now, but a lot of customers are approaching this as if this is the new landscape of privacy expectations, and that eventually this will become more of a global thing and not just be in the EU. So organizations are working to prepare in advance so they're not caught off guard. And then, as I mentioned, significant penalties for non-compliance. And so what we see organizations doing is putting in tighter controls on how they handle and process private data, personally identifiable data. In addition, better data governance tools. And this is where some of the capabilities that we have in Microsoft 365 can help, classifying that data that's sensitive. And then improve data policies and processes. And so this is kind of the journey that we're seeing most customers well on their way against as they prepare for GDPR. Some quick statistics around what we see, this is actually a survey that we fielded amongst organizations that we work with, 1,500 organizations globally, talking to IT DMs, so the decision makers in the IT group. And what we found is that organizations are actually seeing the cloud as a benefit on their journey to GDPR. So 41% of organizations said they're likely to move to the cloud to become compliant. 92 said they feel more confident with their data in the cloud, that they're going to be able to meet these requirements. And then what I think is really great is that the number one concern was not the penalties or the negative repercussions that could be likely subject to these organizations, but actually the right thing, the right focus is in mind around actually protecting personal data. And this is the way that organizations are approaching it. So at Microsoft, we have a commitment around GDPR, and our commitment is that we will be compliant with GDPR across our cloud services by the time it comes into effect. We'll also share our experience. You know, we are subject to GDPR as well. We're a multinational organization with customers in the EU and all around the world. So we're in this with our customers. And then together with our partners, we're committed to helping you prepare on your journey for GDPR. So a couple of components of how we think about this and the contractual commitments that we have in place to support the GDPR readiness. So our cloud services will meet the stringent security requirements. We'll help you manage processes like data subject requests, which are one of the core requirements of GDPR. And we'll provide documentation to help you demonstrate compliance to the regulators. One of the things is actually demonstrating progress on GDPR helps to move the needle forward with the regulators. Of course, Microsoft 365, just to reiterate, it's actually a new bundle of services that we've brought out. It brings together Office 365, Windows 10, and EMS. And you'll start to see more and more capabilities across the board, across these three services for our largest enterprise customers. Our approach and how we're trying to simplify GDPR compliance for our customers is around three things: assessing and managing your compliance risk. And we actually have some capabilities that help organizations do this, to see the regulations that are applicable to them, see the Microsoft controls that have been put in place, and understand the customer controls that should be put in place. And we actually provide guidance within that capability called the Compliance Manager. Second, protect personal data. And a lot of times, first you have to find that personal data before you can protect it. And third, streamline your processes. And so these are really the steps that we're recommending our customers take as they prepare and move forward on the journey towards GDPR. Quickly, when we think about the capabilities that we have in Microsoft 365 around compliance, what we've worked with on our customers is a model around a workflow in compliance. And so with business continuity as the ultimate outcome, we see a kind of a three-phase workflow around assess, manage, and respond. And we have capabilities across this life cycle to help organizations be proactive in their management of their compliance requirements. And so with the Compliance Manager, you get a sense of where you are relative to the applicable regulations. We provide all the privacy documentation on a public website called the Service Trust Portal. We've just updated that with new GDPR resources as of yesterday. And then within the capability itself, we have robust data governance capabilities to help you manage your data and really put an information governance strategy in place, including detecting sensitive data types and classifying that data so that later, when you want to respond to a data subject request, you're actually targeting your search against the specific data that's relevant, in this case, PII data. And then, of course, you can respond to regulatory requests, internal investigations with our e-discovery and our audit capabilities. So in this way, we're really focused on enabling continuous compliance with our Microsoft 365 capabilities. But specifically today, I want to introduce you to the data subject requests capability that we've just launched, which fits within our streamlined processes component of the three-part framework that I mentioned. So we actually just announced this yesterday. It's now in preview. And what we're enabling you to do is to search across your Office 365 contents in a targeted way, including Exchange, SharePoint, OneDrive, Groups, and Sites, and now Teams as well, to get at that data when and if you have a request from an employee or a customer. You can, again, search for over 80 supported sensitive data types that you're able to auto-classify using the capabilities. And then you can download that data to review it further before handing it back to the requester or to provide it to the requester as a part of the mandate. So let's take a quick look at what we've just announced and what's available now in preview. So if you're familiar with the Security and Compliance Center, this is your home for all things security and compliance in Office 365. And we've just added a new tab called Data Privacy within the Security and Compliance Center, brand new. And within that tab, we have the GDPR dashboard as well as the data subject request capability. And so the GDPR dashboard gives you a home to see all the tools that are related to your journey to GDPR, as well as resources to help you ramp up on what GDPR means for your organization. We also have widgets that will provide you insights into how much data has been classified in your environment and other components, and then access to privacy-related tasks, specifically now the DSR capability. So as we drill into the data subject request component, we actually have a request management console that we've just provided. And this is where you can create a new request. You can assign owners to that. And you can kick off the search and then manage the status and the progress of your existing requests. So an organization might have any number of these going at any time. And you can see the progress and the life cycle of these requests here in the convenient dashboard. Just to walk through the flow a little bit, and I can back up if you want to grab a picture of that. But you have the opportunity to establish a case, name that case, provide details to that case, identify the individual who's the subject of that request, and then kick off the search around that content that's related to that requester. Within that, you have the ability to choose across Office 365 locations, both workloads as well as users. So you could identify the specific user whose content you want to search, whether it's their mailbox or their OneDrive, or sites that they might be a part of, teams or groups that they might be a part of, and really refine that search so you're doing a targeted search and not looking across your entire corpus of data. As I mentioned, you can include groups, teams, and sites as well. So it gives you that robust kind of filtering capability into where you're targeting your search. And then once you're in your search, we provide the ability to refine that search with a number of conditions. And so it could be a keyword, or it could be a date range, sender, receiver. There's a number of different ways that you can cull down that data that you're returning to return for review before you provide it to that requester. If you're familiar with labels in Office 365, compliance tags actually maps to labels. So if you take one of our sensitive data types, it could be France PII, which automatically detects the France Social Security number and driver's license numbers. You can then call your search just down to that label so that you're looking for data that only contains that France PII, so that you're not returning all of the business data that you have in your environment to take back to the requester. So in that way, you're actually able to proactively reduce the amount of data you're searching against. And then finally, you have a number of options to export the results. And so you can choose between export options, as you can see here. You can export exchange content. You can get insight into an estimate of how much will be exported at that time. You can also do deduplication for your exchange content, so you're not exporting multiple of the same message via threading. And you can also decide not to include versions of your SharePoint content. So before I wrap up, let me just show you what this looks like in the experience now that I pointed out a few things. Great. So if you're familiar with Security and Compliance Center, this is the home dashboard for the entire center. And now we have a new widget here that takes you right to the GDPR dashboard that's been added. And if I jump down here to the Data Privacy tab, I can see that same component. And so if I jump into the dashboard, I have options for tools. I have ramp up. I also have quick pointers to my capabilities around creating a data subject request, understanding where my active and closed cases are over the last 60 days. I also get insights into the labels in my organization. Are labels being applied? What level of sensitive data do I have within my environment? And then when I jump into the DSR cases, as I showed, you can get the quick view and create that case right from this environment. So quick access, ease of use. Over time, we'll add additional capabilities like more stakeholders and the ability to define roles around a data subject request, as well as the ability to review data within the environment itself. So that was a quick overview of the DSR's capability and just wanted to point that out quickly. Let me jump back to my PowerPoint. in terms of your next steps, if you haven't yet, I would invite you to take the GDPR assessment, which is available at akms.ms/GDPR assessment. And that gives you a step-by-step questionnaire around how ready your organization is for GDPR. Next, I would welcome you to check out the Compliance Manager, which is the capability I mentioned that gives you insights to where your organization is as related to the controls and regulations that are relevant to your organization. And actually gives you a guidepost into what you should implement next in your Microsoft Cloud services. It also includes a bit of a workflow management where you can assign tasks to other people in your organization to do a test and implementation and track that test result. And also export everything into an Excel so that it's audit ready to provide to the regulator in the case that that's required. And then finally, I would invite you to read the announcements that we just made yesterday on blogs.office.com about these new capabilities and others that are related to GDPR, and to try the Data Privacy tab and the DSR's experience in a preview tenant. So that concludes my talk and overview of the data subject request. I'd be happy to take any questions or have any discussion. Hope you have a great rest of the conference. Thank you.